Surfaces. The first prototype was known as Have Blue, a 60% scale model. It had low radar visibility, but was unstable. The full-scale F-117 that followed corrected the instability with computers that constantly adjusted controls. The highly secret aircraft saw its first combat action in Panama during Operation Just Cause and was used to great effect during the first Gulf War. The F-117 is an important part of American military history, and stealth aircraft that have followed are an important element of today's American military.
Dave is running late for work. He's multitasking while driving.
Well, let's see what the radio says about the traffic this morning.
AFN local time is 7:45, and it looks like traffic is stopped on eastbound Route 7.
That's not a problem. Set a GPS, get me around the traffic jam, destination, enter, and...
Anything we do in a car while driving, other than driving, is dangerous. Not paying attention to the road can result in an accident. Practice safe driving habits and keep your eyes where they belong, on the road.
Hey, I just came from this briefing. It was about the status of,
Status of laundry?
No, it was the status of forces agreement. They said that our rights to have...
Rights to free speech, rights to party?
No, our rights under a sofa can vary, depending on whether we're military, a family member,
astronaut! No. What? No, no.
Status of Forces agreements protect the rights of Americans stationed abroad. But they vary depending on whether you're a service member, a DOD civilian, or a family member. Check with your legal office for more information.
Hey, Ben, how's it going?
It's okay. But, you know, I've been thinking of stuff to do around Yokota, and then it occurred to me, I haven't volunteered for anything.
Let me ask you this. Have you heard of 225 Ride?
Of course, but I haven't been drinking, and I don't really need a ride.
I'm talking about giving a ride. See, the 225 Ride program always needs volunteers. You sign up for a four-hour shift, and when you're not driving people home, you're hanging out with other volunteers. Friday and Saturday from 10 at night to 6 in the morning, broken down into two shifts. Why not go with me this weekend? I got with my first sergeant to find out how to sign up.
Giving back to the community? I'm there.
Do you like listening to Eagle 810? Then download the AFN Pacific app for any smartphone or mobile device. Having the app just might win you free lunch. That's right, free lunch. Every Wednesday between 11 and noon at the Yokota Exchange Food Court, one lucky winner will get a free meal at their exchange restaurant of choice. All you have to do is show us that you have the app on your smartphone or mobile device, and a free lunch could be yours. Download the AFN Pacific app today. It just might pay for your lunch.
If you're looking for a good time at Camp Zama, the bowling center's here for you. Come bowl one of 18 lanes, enjoy delicious lunch specials every day at the snack bar, and bring the family out for free bowling every Thursday. You can also join the league if you're looking for some friendly competition. Camp Zama's bowling center is open every day, so head on over and lace up those shoes.
Join Route 5-6 for the Joint Bilateral Airman Professional Enhancement Seminar. The seminar goes from November 19th to the 21st at the Professional Development Center. Route 5-6 invites service members in all branches from E1 to E4 to be a part of this event. The seminar features inspirational discussions, mentorship lessons, and team-building events. Call Route 5-6 at 225-5234 for the details. Build your skills and morale at the Professional Development Center.
The Party Station.
station.
Where you get that from?
plane is blazing, your men wide awake. But at last the day is popping, it goes down for freedom. Don't stop, just keep rolling downhill. Crash and burn, can't stand ball back. You're doing too much, you can't handle all that. Man, it's been way too long. Time to let the whole world play your song. Like me, watch it get surround. Let the country come back, it hits the town. I'm in Miami, New York, in ACL, Houston, and LA. Ask that you tell me about my wrist. You got it from me, and made $50 million. I'm proud of you, dude. But I'm crazy, you don't wanna be like me. I come from me, stuck with me. Yep, get like me, blowing. Slow the whistle. Slow the whistle. Too short. Up all night, baby. Album number 16. Y'all can do that.
President Obama is expected to deliver a warning to Myanmar's president about efforts toward a freer and fairer society. Deputy White House National Security Advisor Ben Rhodes says Obama is concerned that effort has bogged down.
Parts of the reform effort have stalled. Parts have moved forward. And parts we've even seen things move backward. So I think it's a mixed picture.
Tomorrow, Obama will meet with democracy leader Aung San Suu Kyi. While the president may be out of the country, he hasn't stopped working on domestic issues such as immigration reform. Press Secretary Josh Earnest says Obama should be finalizing his plan to take executive action when he comes return when he hears from Homeland Security Secretary Jay Johnson after he gets back to Washington.
The president met very recently, just in the last week, with Secretary Johnson to discuss the status of that. I would anticipate the president will receive some final recommendations from the secretary relatively soon.
Some Republicans on Capitol Hill are trying to block Obama's plans. Nearly half of the border with Mexico is patrolled by drones. It's largely a notice shift to cover stretches where there are no agents, camera towers, ground sensors, or fences. Arizona rancher John Ladd says the drones aren't welcome over his property.
There's no reason to watch me.
Or my family, or my dad.
There have been some 10,000 drone flights, most of them in Texas. The Labor Department says about 290,000 people sought unemployment benefits last week, an increase of about 12,000 over the previous week. The less volatile four-week average increased 6,000 to 285,000. The European Space Agency says its comet lander is resting in the shadow of a cliff, posing a potential problem. Ground controllers are checking to see if it will be possible to shift the lander to make sure its solar panels can catch the sun's rays. This is AP Radio News. Otto's private plane loses a hatch while landing in Berlin. Sandy Kozel tells us more.
Berlin airport authorities say U2 frontman Bono's private plane lost a hatch as it was coming in for a landing in the German capital, but the Irish singer was never in any danger. The rear hatch measured 32 by 40 inches. It's not clear how it came off, but it dropped in the vicinity of the airport on Berlin's southeastern edge. The plane was flying from Dublin. An airport spokesman said it was never in danger of crashing and did land safely. Bono is in Berlin for Germany's Bambi Awards. I'm Sandy Kozel.
Outgoing Arkansas Governor Mike Beebe says he plans to pardon his son for 2003 felony marijuana conviction. Beebe says his 34-year-old son Kyle deserves the same second chance as hundreds of other nonviolent offenders. While his father has granted some 700 pardons during his two terms in office, the younger Beebe waited until this past summer to ask for one. I'm Tim McGuire, AP Radio News.
This is the Wall Street Journal Report. I'm Jennifer Kishika. The number of new claims for jobless benefits rose by 12,000 last week, but remained at levels that indicate an improving labor market. The four-week average, which smooths out volatility, rose by 6,000. Bob Ruska of Fact and Opinion Economics breaks down the numbers.
The rebound in claims to 290,000 is the highest level we've seen for a while. It's an increase of 12,000 on the week, but with numbers below 300,000 are generally considered exceptionally low numbers.
Contemporary art collectors can be summed up in one word right now, insatiable. Christie's International in New York made auction history yesterday when it sold $853 million of contemporary art in a couple of hours. Christie's total easily surpassed its own $600 million expectations as U.S. hedge fund managers and Asian entrepreneurs in black silk lapel suits raised their paddles for nearly everything on offer. On Wall Street, futures are little changed. This is the Wall Street Journal Report.
From the Fox Sports Studios in Los Angeles, Eddie Garcia.
In baseball, for the third time in 4 years, Dodgers pitcher Clayton Kershaw won the National League Cy Young Award. He was a unanimous selection. Indians pitcher Corey Kluber won the American League Cy Young Award. Free agent designated Victor Martinez has re-signed with the Detroit Tigers. He agrees in a four-year deal worth $68 million. College football news, the Florida State University Code of Conduct hearing involving quarterback and former Heisman Trophy winner James Winston has been postponed until December the 1st at the request of Winston's attorney. In the NFL, the St. Louis Rams are making a quarterback change. They're benching Austin Davis and starting Sean Hill against the Broncos this weekend. In NBA games of note, the Rockets win again.
Arnold takes Davis off the dribble, puts him into the spin cycle, rolls right, lays it up and in. DeBiggins taking the real biggest off the dribble and laying it up and in for two. And Dwayne's got a big smile on his face, and he should.
And the Rockets radio on the call. Rockets beat the Timberwolves 113-101. Houston 7-1 on the year in time for the best record in the league.
The station for the defenders of the nation. Gravity on KFN Radio.
Don't want no mediocre, I won't eat no mediocre, yeah, man.